for one reason or other, we found ourselves at Nantucket. And as we got off the boat at Nantucket, I'll never forget it. Ray Charles was singing. And we went to the museum. That's just, you know, just how crazy things are. And the first picture when we got to the museum was of a black naval captain of a whaling ship. And we just like to fell over because of all the things that, you know, that you would have to do to run your boat around in the Atlantic Ocean and get back, that's quite complicated. And here, I guess in the 16th century, maybe in the 16th century, here's an African-American who is a captain of a naval ship. Well, this doesn't fit with the facts that we had been given. Not at all. So we got interested in whaling. And from there, we found out that African-Americans had been in whaling, I guess, since the 1700s. Mm-hmm. And in the later days of the industry, they comprised 90% of it.
And it took us all over looking for them. We went to Seattle. We went to Monterey, to the Maritime Museum there, mm-hmm. down to Barbados. We went mm-hmm. wherever we could find, because there wasn't that much written about it, so we had to do original research, which means you have to go to the places and actually dig it up and find it yourself. So we did that, but we were so proud of the outcome of that book, which was a Coretta Scott King honor book, mm-hmm. and I'm very proud of that. We also learned that these whaling ships were, the Underground Railroad was not a railroad, or a train, but a ship.
One ship.
And that they were the ones that did a lot of the runs with slaves down in the barrels and in the holds of those ships.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Ann B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.